Hello, and welcome back for a new year of KCAT News.
I'm Dylan LaRue. On this edition of KCAT News, we've got an inspiring story of one Mulvane High School athlete.
I'm Samantha Brewster. We'll also bring you a story about some of the new faces in the halls at MHS, a look at sports, and so much more.
Buckle in, because a new season of KCAT News begins right now.
Our first story is about a long-standing tradition here.
It's the annual bonfire. Here's KCAT's Jacob Seville with this report.
The Mulvane High School Student Council planned and hosted the annual bonfire to bring school spirit and the high energy needed for this sports season. Senior President of STUCO, Abby Malinchuk, followed up by telling the events of the bonfire and the reason we celebrate.
In the beginning, we started with the class races. So we had, two-legged race, and then we had our sack race, and then we had wheelbarrow race. And then after that, we had our tug of war between the classes, and seniors won, of course.
Senior member of STUCO, Zachary Sazima, explains what the bonfire is all about and what it has to offer.
It's all about just showing our school spirit, because we burn a dummy that's wearing the uniform of the football team that we play against in the first football game.
And senior student Isaac Waterman gives his summary of what he experienced at the bonfire.
Honestly, I feel like the bonfire is about being with everybody, having a good time, kind of getting that school spirit up. That's why I went. When the bonfire went up, I definitely thought it was a little toasty. Had to step back a bit. Felt like my face was getting melted.
Jacob Seville, KCAT News.
Thank you, Jacob.
The bonfire did the trick, elevating the football team to a 21-14 victory over Independence that week.
It's time to take a look at Mulvane sports.
Here's Kyson Schultz with our sports report. Kyson?
Good evening, sports enthusiasts. I'm Kyson Schultz, and it's time for your latest sports update. We have some exciting developments in the world of high school sports, and let's jump right into it. First up on the gridiron, our varsity football team is showing some impressive form this season with a record of 3 wins and 1 loss. Meanwhile, the JV team is equally impressive, matching the varsity with a 3-1 record. Both teams are putting in the hard work, and we can't wait to see their continued success on the field. Moving over to the soccer pitch, our varsity soccer team has been facing some challenges, but they're holding their own with a record of 3 wins and 7 losses. The JV team has also been showing determination with 2 wins, 3 losses, and 1 tie. Good luck on the rest of the season. And now, let's dive into the world of volleyball. The varsity volleyball team has been putting on a fantastic show with a record of 7 wins and 9 losses. Our JV squad is right there with them, boasting a record of 5 wins and 9 losses. And let's not forget our freshman-sophomore team, who are holding their own with a record of 4 wins and 8 losses. Volleyball fans, you've got a lot to be proud of. That wraps up our sports update for today. We've seen some remarkable performances across the board, and it's clear that our high school athletes are giving it their all. We'll be keeping a close eye on their progress as the season unfolds. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll be back with more sports news soon. Until then, stay tuned and stay active.
Speaking of sports, KCAT's Will Perkins caught up with one athlete who is inspiring his teammate.
We bring you this story about changing the way we see our student athletes.
Runners, take your mark, get set.
I gotta go.
Freshman Jace Lydon, a visually impaired member of the Mulvane High School cross country team, says this is his mindset at the beginning of every race. MHS cross country coach Mr. Roderick says Jace is a real advocate and asset to the team.
Jace does a lot of things so that he helps us out to know what he needs, so he'll let us know if things are going good for him, bad for him. And actually Maddie has been a really good help with that, helping him along and getting him to where he needs to be and just doing what they need to do. They actually, as far as a coach, make it pretty easy on me that they take care of a lot of the stuff.
Jace continues to run no matter what challenges he faces.
Different obstacles on the ground, like holes in the ground or tree roots or other runners in the race. Things that my guide has to call out.
Which that guide is MHS senior Maddie Shaw. She communicates and runs with Jace in each race.
Got a little bit. I'm telling him if there's any uneven ground, if we have to go up, if we have to go down, how far we are in the race, how many people are in front of us, how many people are behind us.
During a race, like for example, the last race we had, the two of them run pretty much side by side, and they had a part in the course where they basically couldn't, and they had to get really close with each other. So doing that while stepping over roots and stuff like that, for them definitely was a challenge.
Most of the time it's pace and mostly the terrain, because he can't see it. It makes him prone to falling.
It was very interesting. I saw him coming up through the middle school and I thought this will be really a completely different experience having somebody with not being able to see to run. And just, I can't imagine that myself. So I'm really impressed that he's able to do it and the stuff, and just being kind of an inspiration for people around. Encourage him, run just like every other runner. Try your very best and just keep going. I know Jace, when I'm at a point, I'll holler at him and I'll tell him, you know, keep going, try to do your best, you know, try to catch people in front of you, or there you've got some people behind you. Obviously he can't see those, but I'm trying to let him know where they're at. And also the course turns right up in front of you and then goes straight for quite a ways, so that way he'll have a general idea of what to expect coming up.
Jace knows that crossing the finish line and never giving up is what makes him a winner every time.
The drive to just keep going, never give up.
In Goddard, Kansas, Will Perkins, KCAT News.
That was really inspiring.
Think you know movies? Samantha Brewster has his quiz for cinema lovers.
We ask staff and students how well they know movies based on emojis. Let's see how they did.
Notebook.
Okay. The Notebook.
That's Notebook.
The Notebook.
Bird in a Box. Birdcage. Bird. That is a movie.
Bird. Bird Box. Yeah.
Eagle Has Landed.
Bird Box.
Eagle Box. Freedom Box.
Oh, Bird Box. Bird Package. Bird Box.
Bird Box.
Shirt on Fire. Composition Notebook.
Shirt Fire Notebook. Shirt Fire Notebook. Chernobyl.
Too hot to handle. I don't know.
Mean Girls.
Yeah, I don't know. I never watched that movie.
Mean Girls.
Polar Express.
Oh, that's the Polar Express.
Polar Express.
Polar Express?
Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
Chocolate Factory, Willy Wonka and Chocolate Factory.
Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory.
Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
Spider, mustache guy, know something, clock, house.
Spider-Man, No Way Home.
Arachnophobia.
Spider-Man, No Way Home.
This year, we welcome several new staff members to the building.
KCAT's Caden Raheski introduces us to some of the new teachers joining us this year.
As the Wilmington High School year kicks off, we have new teachers coming in from everywhere, stepping up to fill in the spots that needed to be filled.
Changing schools it's always a little scary, you don't know the systems and all of that, but it wasn't too bad. It's been 8 years since I've been in the classroom, so that's really the biggest transition issue for me was pre-COVID I was teaching, and now post-COVID. I used Google Classroom before, but not as much as I'm using it now. So just a few things have changed. I haven't used a Promethean board before, and going back to the classroom after being an administrator for 8 years has been a little bit of a change, but it's been great. I love being with the kids every day.
Real well. I love my colleagues here. I didn't dislike anybody up there, but I was looking forward to something that was a little different, and it's everything I hoped it would be. I like it. It's been fun to be here. The pace is really different. I like that you can hear individual voices on passing periods and stuff. It's not a mob. It's not a town in and of itself, but it's got the community piece to it. I like that.
I think Mulvane is awesome. I'm an alum, so I graduated in 85. So this is my school, and it's great to be here. This is a perfect size school, I think.
While holes in teaching were being filled, Mr. Packer teaches classes such as study skills, business communications, business management, consumer and personal finance, and accounting. And Ms. Bernine teaches English 1 and English 2. Coming into Mulvane High School, Ms. Bernine and Mr. Packard have plenty of experience at schools such as, for Ms. Bernine, West Valley High, Derby for 10 years as a teacher and 7 years as an assistant principal, and at Bishop Carroll as an assistant principal for 1 year. And Mr. Packard has taught at schools such as Derby, Norwich, Southwestern College, and the Cali Center in Mulvane.
Well, Norwich was tiny. Little 1A school, played 8-man football. Teeny tiny. And Derby's enormous. Your entire high school is about the size of 1 graduating class at Derby, so it's just a whole different vibe in every way you can imagine.
I would say, honestly, Mulvane compares probably best with Bishop Carroll, which is a little surprising. Not the religious aspect of it, but with the school spirit, because Bishop Carroll has a lot of school spirit, but Mulvane is amazing with school spirit. Derby has more kids who are apathetic and don't care as much about, you know, pep assemblies and that sort of thing. So it's nice to see that and positive interaction between the peers of, you know, the classmates here. I really love that.
Those are just a few of the new teachers here at the Mulvane High School. Kaitlyn Reske, KCAT News.
Although many of the teachers are new to the building, nearly all the new staff have several years teaching experience.
We now present to you a slice of life through the eyes of our very own Kale Ross.
I am Cardi.
Back to things happening at MHS. Imagine attending a new school.
Now imagine school in a completely different country. That's what 3 students are experiencing here at Mulvane.
Here's Mallory Ramos with this look into the lives of our foreign exchange students.
Imagine being in a completely different country, thousands of miles away from your family, making new experiences in high school. That's what these 3 students are experiencing this year at Mulvane High School. Each student has their own way of adjusting.
I don't know. I would like to live new experiences and improve my English. I don't know, make new friends and meet new people and different people.
Probably like to improve my English and know about the culture. And I don't know, I like to travel, so this is like a big experience and opportunity to travel, meet new people. And I don't know, I like the cars here. I mean, the cars, they're like more taller than me, so yeah.
So I know a lot of people who did it in the past, and they all had really good experience, so I think that's kind of what made me want to come here.
I don't know, probably eating different food,
I don't know, it's hard because we eat so healthy there, and then here it's so, like everything is fast food. I don't know, that's difficult, that's like different. And then also like making new friends and
The same as Nora. I mean, like the food here, it's always fast food, and I don't know, it's like more hard to eat healthy here.
Football games and like school activities, school sports. I'm not playing nothing now, but like we don't have school sports in Spain, so I don't know, I think that it's fun.
Probably that everyone's really close and everyone kind of knows each other, and definitely the football games.
The games, probably, yeah. And yeah, the games. And when they put like music in the hallways, I don't know.
I don't know, I think that when I go home to Spain, I'm gonna be more mature. I'm gonna be different than I am now. I don't know.
I already met a lot of new friends here, but I'll probably be happy too, because I kind of miss home and like my old friends, but I kind of have two homes then.
Probably sad, because you come here and it's like you have a new life and new friends. And like when I'm going to be like back in Spain, I'm going to be sad because, well, there's my family and my friends, but here it's like, oh, when I'm going to like see them again, you know? So probably that.
Okay, 3, 2.
Yes.
Thanks, Mallory.
That'll do it for us. For the staff and crew here at KCAT News, I'm Dylan LaRue.
And I'm Samantha Brewster.
And thanks for watching KCAT News.